I don't know about you, but I'm excited to hunt this weekend, December Friday the 3rd, man. It's gonna kick off Great Friday. But I looked at the national weather forecast, and most areas are forecast to be warmer than normal. You know, some folks say weather doesn't matter, but I'm gonna tell you, just my observations and many guys I hunt with, it does matter. If it's 10, 20% warmer than normal, and this time of year, deer got a layer of fat on them and longer hair, they're just not as prone to be active during daylight hours. And maybe that's just where hunters hunt and where deer with GPS collars walk. I'm not sure, but I promise you, most hunters will say, man, when it's really hot, I don't see as many deer out there. Certainly if you're driving through the Midwest, you're going through corn or bean country and they've cut some, there's some spilled grain. If it's warmer than normal, you won't see hardly deer in the field till after dark. But if it's colder than normal, those fields will load up well before dark. No doubt about it, deer are gonna move almost every single day. So if it's warmer than normal where you are, you might wanna think about being closer to the bedding area in that afternoon hunt and try to catch deer moving to food. Let's look at the biology a little bit. You know, we're on that downside of the curve. Big percentage of the adult does have been bred. There's still some out there. There's still gonna be some chasing. And what's coming on, we're early in the cycle. Depending on how healthy the deer are where you're hunting, but some of those fawns will reach 70 plus minus pounds, and that's about the time a female fawn will reach puberty. So you're gonna have a double whammy going on. You still got some does that are receptive, or maybe some that were bred and it didn't take early on, so they're gonna cycle through again, and you're starting to have some fawns become receptive. Now, if you've had a pretty good doe harvest like here at the Proving Grounds, some of those fawns, you know, they're not with mom right now, so they're on a pattern, food, cover, and they typically will feed in open food plots. So if you've got some reconnaissance cameras or some trail cameras out and you're seeing a bunch of fawns, you've had a big doe harvest, you've got a bunch of fawns hanging around a food plot, that can be a great place this weekend, certainly going into the upcoming weekends, to tag a mature buck. Man, I hope you tag a wagon full of venison for you and your family. If you're like us, you're still working on that doe harvest a little bit, get out there if you've already tagged a buck, try to take a doe down, and most importantly, just enjoy your time out in creation and find some quiet time to seek the Creator's will for your life. Thanks for watching Growing Deer.